This is all for you.
No,
you can come in here.
You sure?
Yep.
Well, we'll go around the other way.
You sure?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's fine. You can see here.
If I'm in your way, you may have.
Thank you.
I got it from a store.
It's called Iagra.
I
living stations of the cross, as produced by the youth of our school. We hope that this beautiful prayer of the church will draw you closer to our Lord, just as it has enriched our faith as we prepare for this evening. So that all may participate fully in this prayer, we ask that you take a moment to silence your cell phones. Stations of the Cross follows the suffering of Jesus, when he was condemned to death and ending with his burial in the tomb. One of the earliest records of this tradition of praying through Jesus' suffering was recorded in a letter by a French pilgrim, Egeria, in the 4th century. The stations help us to reflect on the suffering of Jesus for our sins and the need for Christian virtue. Let us pray. Oh Jesus, you're about to walk
through the stages of your agony and death. We have spent a brief time renewing the sacrifices that give us the life.
And bring us along the first station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. From the Gospel, according to Matthew, Pilate said to them,
"Then what should I do with Jesus, who is called the Messiah?"
All of them said,
"Let him be crucified."
Then he asked,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
But they shouted all the more,
"Let him be crucified."
So he released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Jesus' enemies captured him. They made fun of him all night. They really wanted to kill him, but someone else had to do it. So they brought Jesus to Pilate. You are there. You can see that Pilate is going to do what the crowd says. What do you want to say to Jesus as Pilate condemns him to death? Let us pray. Dear Lord,
many times in families, parents are misunderstood by children, and children are misunderstood by parents. Husbands and wives misjudge each other. Siblings falsely accuse each other. When we are falsely accused, dear Lord, give us the strength to bear the injustice with the patience of our way of following you on the way to the cross. We love you, Jesus.
Christ carried our sins in his body on the cross. He did this so that we would stop living for sin and start living for what is right. And we are healed because of his wounds. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, teach me to remember that when I sin, it hurts.
You are.
Christ, and we bless you.
As by your holy cross have redeemed the world.
Consider the first call of Jesus. Loss of blood from the scourging and crowning of thorns have so weakened him that he could hardly walk. And yet, he had to carry that great load upon his shoulders. As the soldiers struck him cruelly, he fell several times under the heavy cross. Let us learn from Jesus, who humbled himself, to discover our true greatness by bending low before God. Let us pray.
Dear Jesus,
all these things in her heart. In her heart, Mary kept the words of the angel spoken to her in the beginning. Do not be afraid, Mary. The disciples fled, yet she did not flee. She stayed there, with a mother's courage, a mother's fidelity, a mother's goodness, and a faith which did not leave her in the hour of darkness. Blessed is she who believed. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? Yes, in this moment, Jesus knows, he will find faith. In this hour, this is a great consolation. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, teach me to have courage. Help me to follow the example of Mother Mary, saying yes to you no matter what.
You're a good, good Father.
Whenever we show kindness to the suffering, the persecuted, and the defenseless, and share in their suffering, we hope to carry that same cross of Jesus. In this way, we obtain salvation and help contribute to the salvation of the world. Let us pray.
Do you and me, Jesus, teach me to remember that I help you, and I show kindness to others for your sake. You're a good, good Father.
You're a good, good Father. To you.
station, Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. Imagine, the dry sand kicked up from the street is getting in our Savior's eyes and nose. He can even taste the dirt. But he keeps going. Up ahead, a lady pushes past the soldiers and wipes Jesus' face with a cool wet towel. Veronica lives out the gospel message. I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and gave me something to drink. I was alone and away from home, and you invited me into your house. I was without clothes, and you gave me something to wear. I was sick, and you cared for me. I was in prison, and you visited me. Anything you did for any of my people here, you also did for me. Veronica finds a way to offer sweet and gentle mercy. She steps forward, even when many in the crowd must mock her as they mock you. Let us pray. Dear Jesus,
help me to be like Veronica, to never be afraid to say I belong to you and enter. Help me to bring soothing, gentle mercy to others.
Who I am, caused by your holy cross to have redeemed the world.
Consider how Jesus Christ falls for the third time. He stumbles and falls to the ground. The cross crushes him with its weight, and the people around wonder if he is not dead already. But no, once more he climbs to his feet and struggles forward up the hill. You cannot grieve to see Jesus so weak and helpless. Yet it is a comfort to know that our Lord understands our sufferings from his own experience. How much God has loved us that he experienced this kind of pain and offered us this example of courage. We cry out from the depth of our soul, I can bear the suffering no more. And hear God whisper, I understand. We are discouraged after many falls, particularly from addictions and repeated sins. Can we hear God say to our innermost being, keep going, I know how hard it is to rise. Through the humiliation of his third fall, Jesus gives us all the courage and perseverance to take up our crosses and follow him. Let us pray.
Jesus, teach me never to be discouraged, even if I keep falling into the same sin. Help me to begin again, to run to you. If I try, you will help. When we are together, I can be the person you want me to be.
You're a good, good Father. Soon you are. Soon you are. Soon you are.
Among them by casting lots. Then they sat down and kept watch over him there. The Lord passes through all the stations steps of man's fall from grace, yet each of these steps for all its bitterness becomes a step towards our redemption. This is how he carries home the lost sheep. Let us pray. Dear Jesus,
help me to be willing to give up earthly surroundings, in keeping them because I am so separated from you. You suffered so much for me. Surely I can make sacrifices for you.
You're a good, good Father. Soon you are. Soon you are. Soon you are. And I'm loved by you. Soon I am.
And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying,
you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross.
So also the chief priests with the scribes and elders mocked him, saying,
he saved others, he cannot save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down from the cross and we will believe in him.
Our Lord, who was completely righteous and pure, gave himself over to the hideous sufferings of the cross, so we might have life. Let us pray. Dear Jesus,
help me to be docile.
Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani.
That is,
my God, why have you forsaken me?
And some of the bystanders hearing him said,
this man is calling Elijah.
And one of them at once ran and took a sponge, filled it with vinegar, and put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said,
wait, let us see if Elijah comes to save him.
And Jesus cried out again with a loud voice and yielded up his spirit. When the centurion and those who were with him, keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what took place, they were filled with awe and said,
truly, this was the Son of God.
Faith to withstand moments of confusion, a law of eternal rules, a constant
14th station, Jesus laid in his tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Blessed are your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
In the Gospel according to Matthew, Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen shroud, laid in his new tomb, which he had hewn in the rock, and rolled a great stone to the door of the tomb, and departed. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were there, sitting opposite the sepulchre. Jesus, disgraced and mistreated, is honorably buried in the new tomb. Nicodemus brings a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100-pound weight, which gives off a precious scent. In the sun self offering at his anointing in Bethany, he sees an excess which evokes God's generous and superabundant love. God offers himself willingly. God's measure is superabundance, and we, for our part, should consider nothing too much for God. This is the teaching of Jesus himself in the Sermon on the Mount. But we should also remember the words of St. Paul, who says that God, through us, spreads the fragrance of the knowledge of Christ everywhere. We are the aroma of Christ. Let us pray.
Dear Jesus, help me to walk by the cross, that you may remind me to confess to myself. Help me to pray for the Christ of the world around me, so that I and all who are called may turn in honor to our heavenly Father.
I know that you are near. Amen.
Amen.
I just wanted to thank 7th grade so much for your hard work these last few weeks, putting this together and having changes done at 2 in literally the last minute. So I thank you guys very much for all that you have done and your witness to Christ. How many of you guys are ready for Easter break? More importantly, teachers, are we ready for Easter break? Yeah. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for being here and for praying these Stations of the Cross with us today. As we leave, let's do so in a prayerful quietness, and then